Hello friends, hope you had a great holidays. Let's come back to our tutorials. So in this episode we are going to finish creation of custom attribute for address entity. We will add this custom attribute to three customer forms. We will also declare extension attribute for address entity, and it will be our custom attribute, so system will be able to properly process and store value of this custom attribute into database, and we will see how everything works and how everything looks in Magento admin panel. My name is Max Pronko and you're watching Magento Dev Channel. In our previous video, we've added configuration for our custom attribute called custom, and this configuration is required to install attribute in the system. However, user-defined setting is not required here and should not be here at all, because user defined used only in case attribute created from admin panel. And if we will set it to true via install data script, it will lead to errors and there won't be any chance to install, to save or process attribute properly or values properly when working with this attribute in forms. So let's go ahead and remove it. What we would like to do is to add this custom attribute into forms. So this attribute will be visible in forms. So let's add dependency. Actually, let's add it here. Use Magento EV model config. So we need config class, and it would be EV config. And this EV config will return us installed or stored in database attribute. EV config will give us access to instance of newly created attribute. So in our case, we can say get attribute and request it by type of entity. And attribute code. And this would be our custom attribute. Once we have instance of attribute, we can go ahead and say set data used in forms as a key, and as value we will pass array of form codes, admin HTML, customer address, admin HTML customer address will be used for admin panel, so this attribute will be shown on admin panel when we are going to add customer address. Second form is customer address edit. And lastly, customer register address. So what we're saying here is that we want to add our custom attribute into three forms. And we have to trigger save. And I'm using save method from model, in this case entity attribute model, and it's deprecated, right? Only because there is still room for improvement, room for refactoring in customer address. And for instance, if I will be using address repository, it will not process used in forms key and will not store into additional table. But in future, I hope it will going to be improved.
What we will do next, we will run setup upgrade, but before doing it, let's add dependency for our module. And we will say that our module dependent on Magento customer module. Let's check whether our module is enabled. Module status. All right. Bin Magento setup upgrade. And so we have everything here. Let's run setup upgrade command. It will take a couple of seconds to upgrade our database. Our expectation is that our custom attribute is installed and we can see it in admin panel. Add new customer. So here is our custom attribute. Everything looks fine. However, in order to for the system to understand and save this custom attribute value, we have to add extension attribute configuration. Into our module. Extension attributes.xml. And in this configuration, we would like to add extension attribute to Magento customer API data address interface. And we will say attribute name custom and type string. Very simple extension. And let's clean cache. All right. So let's try to save our new customer with custom attribute. First name, last name, email, looks good, and let's say it's our default billing and shipping. Country and city. Phone number. We will say our value into custom. And let's save it. Save and continue edit. All right, well, I already have such email. Let me add unique email. Let's go back and say that this is our default and billing, default billing and shipping addresses. So we will see section. And as you see, we have new attribute called custom with our value. But in order to see it in this form, we should also update, and I already updated in my database. Customer configuration saying that I have custom attribute and here is label for custom attribute. You can say different label. here and actual code of the attribute. So once we have value for this attribute, we will render it with label custom label and value. Let's save config, and it's located in address templates. Flush cache. And let's go back to all customers. So for this customer grid to be updated, we have to run index array index. And we will see all new records. So I already executed this command, and my customer has updated label, says label custom for our custom attribute. This is all for today. I will upload code to github.com/mcsbronco/magento2custom-attribute. So in this repository, you will see all parts. So currently I have part number one, and this would be part number two. And I will upload shortly.
If you like to hear more about migration from Magento 1 to Magento 2, I'm planning to upload a video from Magento Imagine where we did a session, 45-minute session, discussing about the migration and best practices. If you like my videos, don't forget to click this nice red subscribe button, and you will get notifications and updates from this channel on a weekly basis. So all fresh content, you will get it immediately, and you will know when to go to YouTube and see new version of Magento Dev Channel tutorial. If you have any questions related to this tutorial or previous tutorials I uploaded, feel free to comment. I will be happy to discuss, help, and provide all answer, all knowledge I know. And I will see you next week. Bye.